To understand the impact of what became known as his Rivers of Blood speech, I'm meeting Wolverhampton-born cultural historian, Professor Patrick Vernon, OBE. Patrick, how would you describe the situation in 1968, after there had been immigration into Britain for some time?
Yeah, I think Britain was going through a kind of a crisis of identity. As a result of the 1948 British Nationality Act, that gave the permission for people from the colonies, from the Caribbean, Africa, Southeast Asia, to come to Britain as British citizens. My parents' generation came here to contribute to the NHS, manufacturing, retail, transport, to help to rebuild Britain after the Second World War. That was never communicated clearly by successive governments.
So Enoch Powell breaks all taboos by making this extraordinarily explicit speech about immigration.
Yes.
And also predicting that it will lead to bloodshed.
Yes.
What do you think is the reaction and the consequence of that speech?
He was dismissed by the shadow cabinet. In Wolverhampton itself, there was an increase in hate crime against the Caribbean and Southeast Asian community. Explicit racist language was used. He talked about the concerns of white parents that immigrant children would bring down the educational standards. And that led to a number of parents removing their children from schools or demanding or putting pressure on educational authorities about the number of black and Asian children in classrooms. And actually, this had an impact on me directly. I was born in Wolverhampton, and at the time, me and my sister, we were bussed around different schools for several months.
It's more than half a century since Enoch Powell's speech, and here we are still talking about it.
Yes.
I mean, why do you think that is?
Well, it's part of history. We know that, and that's probably why we're debating it. But I think his speech was has influenced politicians across all political parties the last 50 years. And in many ways, it's has an impact on immigration conversations, even today in Britain. And that is part of the legacy, unfortunately, of Enoch Powell.